Hey guys, it's Twisty.
It's D Fresh.
We just got back from seeing the new movie Rock of Ages, starring Tom Cruise, Alec Baldwin, Russell
Brand,
and Mary J. Blige, just to name a few. And it was actually pretty good. It ranks as far as musicals go. I'd say it does pretty good as far as a modern day musical.
It was really, I thoroughly enjoyed it. They picked the right song choice. They picked the right actresses and actors and
everyone that could sing. Everyone that sung well. Yeah.
Which I was very surprised, Russell Brand. You have a very okay voice.
Even Alec Baldwin and
Tom Cruise.
That was him.
Who knew?
We all knew Mary J. Blige could sing.
Tom Cruise is a jack of all trades, apparently.
Yeah,
he can add singer to his list.
Yeah, so he took vocal lessons working with Adam. Not Adam was his vocal teacher, but you know, when he first went on, and they took vocal lessons, and you know, he turned out to be a pleasant surprise to everyone. So, Tom Cruise can sing.
You?
I'm not gonna say he's not a record deal, but he can sing.
Also, two newcomers. Not really for sure how new Julianne Hough is to
acting.
I've heard her name before. I'm in Hollywood with my suitcase.
Are you new to town?
Yes.
Yeah, let me introduce you to culture.
No. Oh, my CD. Excuse me. Records. My vinyls, they're gone. Stupid church lane.
But I want to say Diego Boneta's were fairly new. Maybe his first movie, I'm not really sure.
Diego Boneta, he played Drew.
He may have a small biography.
But the leading man.
This will definitely probably be a breakout role for him, especially among all these other talented people. And he gets to be the main star.
I know.
So, it's definitely a nice little change. Alright, talk about things that we liked for the movie, starting off. The singing. The singing was awesome. The dancing was good. The song choice was perfect. It fit the scenes.
Yeah. Adam Shankman, you did a very good job.
Yeah, it was very nicely put together. Mm-hmm. It was
edited really well.
It was believable, you know, and you know, even though you kind of just walking along and just bust out the song, it didn't feel all weird.
Yeah,
which you know sometimes in
musicals
it felt a little weird because you didn't begin to wonder, can other people hear you?
Did I just sing this now?
Right, you know, is that my intro for this? So. I was pleasantly surprised with that. Of course, with the actors, actresses they chose, I think that was all nice. I really didn't see any really major issues, especially, which is supposed to be musical, with the main point of the whole movie. And it was a nice, spectacular, like, in your face with certain things, and it just worked out well.
Like, blame.
So, definitely, ranks really have musicals.
Yeah.
Now, as far as a few things we didn't like about it, although, It was quirky funny. I forgot to mention that it was funny.
Yes, it was. I believe it showed Adam's personality a little more.
Yeah, it had its little quirky little moments where like certain people fell in love and you're like, are you serious? Oh my gosh, gross.
We definitely have to go see the movie.
Right. I cannot think of the name of the song right now that they were singing, but it fit so perfectly.
Yeah.
And then you got the little naughty mayor with a little sick little fetish. I don't know. It was a lot of little fun things. And then, you know, you have like this great, like, supposed to be, you know, rambunctious sex scene. And then it'll end with like someone falling off the whole thing. So it had nice quirky moments, which always brought you back to reality that, hey, don't take it too seriously.
Yeah.
But as far as things we didn't like about it, even though it was great musically, it was very entertaining to watch. It was the little plot issues. There were some jumps and some things that really weren't explained. I thought that the first 20-some minutes of the movie flew, well, not the first 20, I would say the first 5-10 minutes flew by really fast.
Yeah.
You meet her,
you meet him, they're in love, and writing songs together.
Right, and you just like zoom Like, and then it gets to the night where Stacey Jackson performed, and it's like the movie just kind of just you're moving like at this pace, and then just and this scene lasts like forever. From people having scenarios, from people having just their own random songs.
But it wasn't just the scene; it was the night.
Yeah, it was a long night.
It felt like it was a long night.
It really, really did. I mean, from the time you learn out that the little boy is you know gonna get to kind of showcase his first talent, to you know finally meeting Stacey Jacks, to seeing him interview, to seeing this whole big confusion scene, which I won't ruin it for you, but this whole big confusion scene between the lead, the two main male and female leads, where they have a misunderstanding. And all this happens in one night, and you're just like, this is a lot to take in, and it's moving a little slow. Mm. So I was a little put back by that. Other than that,
some of the writing wasn't.
Like, some of the lines weren't really that great, but I think that this is one of those times where some of the lines would work better maybe if it was on stage. Because I would excuse some of that far stage. Because some of that stuff is kind of like you have to explain the plot. You have to do the... And it's all through speaking. Which, in movies, technically, to an extent, you kind of have to do the same thing. But you can be a little bit more creative with a movie. And you can't with a play.
Yeah.
So, I think that there was a few times where you possibly could have made a few other choices with what you did. What you focused on seemed sometimes irrelevant. And then it's like... You were trying to get to this scene, and so you just kind of muddle this scene. When the girl falls at her lowest, and you know, and Mary J. Blige's character's final truth, which Mary J. Blige was introduced, like, showing off in the credits, and she's at the end of the movie. My name, Justice. Justice. Let me show you my strip joint place.
Okay, strange black lady. Drew, is that you?
Is that you, Sherry?
Yes. It is.
What happened?
What happened to you?
What are you doing now?
I'm a dance instructor. What about you?
I'm a big time music person.
Yeah, right. Okay, I'm a stripper.
I'm in the boy band.
I'm sorry, you mean?
Guys. ZZZ. I mean, it's like I said, you have to meet the girl at the lowest. I mean, to get her at her lowest, she had to be at one of her highest. So you have to bring her on down. Step on her a couple times. Kick her down for a little bit. Spit on her. Yeah. And then, you know, Mary finds her. So, I was a little bit, you know, taken aback by that. So,
but other than that, it's a fun movie. Got nice songs. If you just want to go rock out and have a little mini concert in the movie theater.
Right. If you're very familiar with a lot of these songs, I mean, you probably sing along and join in. They do some nice mashups between two different songs.
So they did do that.
It's really nice in some instances. It's just some of the stuff I just didn't. It was plot issues, more or less, for me. Plot lines. That, you know, you're just aware of that this could have been a little bit better. Maybe if it had been stronger writing, maybe depending on who wrote it. I'm not familiar with the screenwriters. They could have been doing this for years. I just think that they flubbed up on a few things with this movie. But then again, that could have been some editing things. Because there are certain scenes that I felt like they started, but they started after something else had happened. Mm-hmm. It was edited out. I don't know what happened. And because of that, it seemed like a weird scene, or it seemed like a weird jump. What? But I could follow. I was never lost. I just didn't understand certain scenes. I understood the entire plot of the movie, though. So, having said that, I think that it's worth seeing. Mm-hmm. I would definitely give it at least, what do you say, 4, maybe?
Yeah.
I'll give it a straight 4. I don't think it deserves any more or any less than a straight 4. It's fine. Like I said, check it out. It's worth seeing.
You'll get to see Tom Cruise in buttless chaps.
Yeah, so you'll get to see his booty. So if you're looking to see that, this might be the movie for you. So check it out. Go see it. Film theaters right now.
Yeah.
It's Tom Cruise, Alec Baldwin, Mary J. Blige.
Diego Boneta, Julian Hough, Russell Brand.
Catherine Zeta-Jones.
Oh, yeah, her.
Oh, I forgot about her. Patty Cakes. You'll get it once you see it.
Bryan Cranston, the dad from Malcolm in the Middle.
Yeah. Which, once again, he does comedy. He does it awkwardly funny.
It is. He's the mayor that we talked about with the little naughty fetish.
So, very good. Check it out. See it. Catch you later. It's twisted.
Feverish. This is a cool vinyl record.
I'm just sitting, 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 sitting. I'm just staring at the vinyl record. Sitting, 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 sitting.
I'm just staring at the vinyl record.
Sitting, 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 sitting.
I'm just staring at the vinyl record.
Sitting, sitting,
sitting. Yes, America, we have problems.
Yes, this is true.